right? All right, so this is chapter 6. Chapter 6 is basic. That's the key word, basic. Option. Strategies. All right, we're beginning. Get ready.
Where's the red color?
Let's see. Basic. Basic means simple, means easy, in the sense of having a call, having a put, having a stock, or combining the stock with a call or with a put. So it's amazingly simple, amazingly easy, and it should go hopefully very, very quickly. There are three ways to go about this. One way to go about this is numerically or analytically. We write formulas. I usually don't do that a lot. You can see it in the book. The second one is graphical. That's the most important one. And the third one is a simple and easy example to understand. Sometimes we do examples. Most of the time we don't need example. You need to understand the picture. You need to understand the graph. And you need to understand how the graph works. You need to be able to think through. In the sense that when you're given certain strategy, that you are able to draw the chart yourself. That's what is important. Now, for this chapter 6, it's all very easy. You got the standard terminology, and standard notation. Maybe I will not need it. Let's go over quickly. C stands for the price of the call, okay? P is for the price of the put. S0 is the current price of the underlying. It's exactly the same notation. ST is the price of the underlying at expiration. X is the exercise price. Nothing really special here. I did the ST. And now they use this Greek letter called pi, standing for profit, okay? Because you got P, one over here, you can't use P for profit, use the letter, Greek letter pi for profit. And then you're gonna have some profit equations. Let's see what else we got. We got N, standing for the number of assets. If it's number of calls, will become N C, okay? If it's the number of puts, becomes NP. And if it's the number of stock, the underline becomes NS, okay? If the number is positive, we are simply long, okay? You need to zoom in occasionally with the camera guy. Zoom in occasionally, a little bit more. Zoom in a little bit, right? So keep zoom in, zoom out. You gotta, you know, a little bit. So, you guys are having fun. And if N is negative, this means you're short. It's just a general notation. You got various, we call profit equations. Uh, profit equations, and you have profit equations for various things. For example, for a stock, the profit equation is very simple. It is the price of the stock, ST, at time T when you sell it, minus S0. So this is the price of the stock. So this is the difference from the buy and the sale. And then you multiply it by the number of shares. So if you got N, S, this is multiplication. Okay, so this is a simple profit equation. This is if you want to do everything analytically and you want to write out everything. If you want to write out for a call, we have, remember, for one call, it's the maximum. That's what we did last time. That's what we did long time ago. For a call, this is for a call. You got the maximum of 0, and then you got ST minus X. ST minus X. This is the stock minus the strike price. And let's see what else we got. So this is the maximum, and then you subtract the price of the call. This, if you remember, we call payoff. This is what is going to pay you off at the end, at expiration. This is the initial price. So this is what you get. This is what you paid. Okay? And all of this will be simply by the number of calls. This one's not very good. Oh, this is where the right one is. Okay, so this is for a call. And it's quite similar for a put. P for put. It's going to be the payoff. Maximum. Now it's got to be 0, and it's going to be X minus SD. So that's the payoff of the put minus the price. So this is the net gain. The net gain, we incorrectly call it profit. I'll give you a little lecture in about 2 minutes. And all of this is multiplied by the number of puts. Okay. Let's educate you. I think maybe I did. I don't know if I do, but all students need it, is to clarify profit. Camera, right? Profit. In finance, remember, in finance, there is no profit. Profit does not exist in the subject of finance. All right? Profit is a concept. This is sound good basic education, okay, which some students and teachers usually get. Profit is the result of economic activity. Economic activity. You need to have an economic activity. An economic activity comes from business. Okay? Profit requires to have revenue, okay, and it requires to have some cost, which we say is expense. And revenue in business or economic activity requires the sale of product or service. In finance, you don't have revenues. There is no concept of revenues, okay? Because there is no business activity. There is no concept of selling products or selling services, okay? That does not exist in finance. It is not the subject of finance. Finance does not study these things, okay? In finance, we have the concept of gain. And gain is associated of buying and selling an asset. So you get gains when you buy and afterwards you sell an asset. And that asset we usually call investment. In finance, there is no revenue, okay? And that is a concept. You may have what's called a service revenue, okay? We're gonna discuss this some other time in terms of a financial institution provides advice, okay? But in finance, we have investments, and investments are associated with gains, okay? And when you normalize the gain, so for example, you have a call which you, let's say, buy for $7 and you sell it for $14, your gain is $7. And you can convert the gain to return. So in finance, we work with gains, which is the difference between buying and selling of an asset, whether it's a stock or an option, okay? And returns, when you normalize the gain to the purchase price of the asset. So, technically, we're not talking about profit equations, we're talking about gain equation, how much you gain, okay? So this is an incorrect or poor terminology, but you have to make a difference between profit and gain, okay? A lot of times investors talk, oh, I made so much profit on an investment. Well, investments don't make profit, okay? So you buy a house for $1 million and you sell it for $2 million, you made the gain of $1 million. It's not a profit, okay, for the house. So that's basic terminology in here. Let's see what else we got. All right, you may have different holding period. It's the same as before. Holding period, you will have T0, which is like now. Then you have zero. Then you have here T is the time. And then you have T1 and T2. So T2 is always going to be less than T, you know? So T2 happens before the expiration. And T1 we always say is earlier than T2. That's only for convenience. So we can order time as T1, T2, T3, T4, and this is time in sequence. So T1 is earlier than T2, T2 is earlier. It's just simple and easy notification. When we write the one or the other, we know what we mean. Okay, let's see. The assumptions are fairly straightforward. The first assumption is no taxes. That's the standard one. We can introduce taxes, but it doesn't really help a lot. It's just we call this, remember I explained in the first lecture, we call this a simplifying assumption. It makes things simpler and you don't lose much in it. Second one is no cost, as in no expenses. Meaning when you buy and when you sell, you don't have commissions for brokers and things like that. And number three is no dividends. This is just to make things simplify. Okay, no dividends. Let's see what else we got. The next fundamental concept is that of a toll. You guys study already investments, right? You know what's a bull? In a bull market. So, bull market is a market which trends upward. In other words, a market whose price has an upward trend. Bear market. Is a market whose price, we should know, is downward moving, okay? The trend is downward. From here, a bull is an investor who has expectations of a rising price. Investor expecting higher prices. A bear is an investor expecting lower prices. Okay? And then you have a bull strategy. Bull strategy. Strategy which profits from a rising price. A different way of saying is a strategy which profits in a bull market. And bear strategy. Strategy which profits from a bear market. In other words, strategy which profits when prices go down. Now, here is something which students have very hard times to understand. Not all strategies are bull strategies and bear strategies. In other words, you may have a strategy which does not profit when the price goes up, but it does not profit when the price goes down either. And people think this kind of like impossible. Well, it is possible. It's part of my job to explain it later on today. And even now, I'll introduce the concept now, but I'll use it a couple of hours later to make it complete. The third type of strategy is called volatility strategy. A volatility strategy is a strategy which profits from a changing volatility, from a changing volatility. In other words, a volatility strategy changes either when the volatility increases or when the volatility decreases. Now let's introduce the next concept. The next concept is, and they use it in practice, not in the book, but when you talk, when you listen to people on TV, on radio, and analysts, they call it long vol. When they say vol, they always mean volatility. They don't mean volume, okay? So, long volatility is a strategy which profits from unanticipated increases in volatility, from a rising volatility. In other words, you go long volatility, you will profit if the volatility increases. And then short volatility. Strategy. This is short volatility strategy. Is a strategy which profits from falling volatility. Okay? So, just a simple example, it's gonna come down the road with a number of, when we discuss the volatility strategies. You may assume a volatility strategy which is not a bull strategy and it is not a bear strategy. You will not profit when the price goes up, and you're not gonna profit when the price goes down, okay? You're actually gonna profit when the price stays about the same, okay? It's not possible with a stock. So, when you have a stock, you may have only a bull strategy or a bear strategy. With a stock, you either bet and profit on the upside or bet and profit on the downside. With derivatives, you may have a bull strategy profiting on the upside, a bear strategy profiting on the downside, or you may have a volatility strategy which does not profit with the up or downside, but profits in the change of volatility, okay? That's coming later, so it's important to understand. Number two, okay, I'll delete and write again over here, is section number two, stock transactions. Stock transactions. So six. All right, six. 2, stock transactions. Six, two, one. We say buy stock. When you say buy stock, I'll actually use equal sign, means we go long. We're long the stock, and going long the stock is a bull strategy. This is the simplest, the easiest, the most common sense strategy that any investor can use. The easiest strategy which everybody in the world uses, even the dumbest person knows and understands, is going long real estate. As in, you buy a house. If the price goes up, you profit. If the price goes down, you lose. This is exactly the same thing for stocks, okay? You buy, it goes up, you profit. It's a bull strategy. Nothing more, nothing less. The profit equation I already wrote for you, nothing really special there. Pi equals the number of shares, SD minus S0. This representing the gain per share multiplied by the number of shares. Common sense, simple, easy. The picture, again, is very simple. It should be on, for me, it's page 188. What's your page? Is the difference 5 pages now? 193 for you?
Yeah.
On 193, the picture is by a stock, and it's just a simple, straightforward one. This is the purchase price over here. If the price goes down, it's a 45 degree line. If the price goes down, you lose. And if the price goes up, you gain. And that's all there is. It's common sense, nothing confusing, nothing special, nothing difficult. 6-2-2 is sell stock. And sell stock is a means you sell short. You take a short position. And that's a bear strategy. And the profit equation is essentially the same. Again, you may have to change the sign. It's common sense. You first sell today, and then you buy. We say, let's use this term here to write it in English, to buy back. To buy back. So, in English, when you sell the stock short, we sell the stock short. Short selling. After that, when you buy, you say you buy back. And we say you buy back to cover. Short covering, okay? Let's see what we got for the short cover. Well, not much. It's the same thing anyway. Let's see what else we got. Well, that's it. Very easy. 6-3. Call. Call option. 6-3-1 is fairly straightforward. Is buy. Buy a call. When you buy the call, you're actually, remember the word buy means long. And in this particular case, this happens to be, as we will show in a minute, this happens to be a bull strategy. In other words, we say buying a call bets that the price goes up. To bet the price goes up means you will profit if the price goes up, and you will lose if the price goes down. Let's see what we got in here. Well, we already did the chart before. Let's try, I'll do the chart over here. Bigger and nicer. So that you can see how it works. Look, guys, for you, it's important to think and pay attention to understand these charts, to understand each one of them. All right, so what do we have? You have a point called break-even point. The loss on a call is fixed. This is the maximum loss. Maximum loss. And the maximum loss, the worst you can possibly ever lose when you buy the call is the purchase. What's going on, guys? What's going on?
I don't know. It's I don't know.
Yeah. Well, sometimes it's flick. Yeah. Well. Oh, this means that we're running on battery.
There is no electricity. Okay. All right. Let's close and see what.